In 1948, a Frenchman named Georges de Mestral returned from a relaxing nature hike with his dog to find himself and the dog covered with burrs. Little did he know, these annoying prickly seeds would be the inspiration for one of the world's most popular fasteners, Velcro. An avid outdoorsman, de Mestral returned from one of his many hikes in 1948 to find his dog, as well as himself, covered in burrs. But instead of brushing them off as he usually did, de Mestral examined the clingy seeds under his microscope. What he saw through the lens amazed him. Burrs are plant seeds covered in small hooks. These hooks attach to the fur of animals, spreading the plant as far as the carrier animal travels. De Mestral realized that these hooks could form the basis of a new type of fastener. By creating pieces of cloth with burr-like hooks woven into them, two pieces of de Mestral's fastener could be joined. De Mestral experimented with various cloths and hook-making processes for 3 years, usually working with small batches of custom-woven cotton. The velvet-like appearance of this original cloth lent the product its name, which De Mestral derived from the French words for velvet, velour, and hook, crochet. The result was Velcro. De Mestral's original invention utilized two pieces of similar cloth. Both sides had hooks for grabbing. By 1988, the process of manufacturing, combined with advances in plastic and especially nylon, led to what we today commonly think of as Velcro. Today, most hook and loop fasteners have hooks on only one side. A strip of heated plastic is fed through special rollers, which deform the plastic into hooks. The resulting hooks attach to soft cloth strips, which are woven thickly to provide an adequate number of loops for the hooks to grab. Today, the Velcro Company is one of the largest producers of hook and loop fasteners, which are used in almost every field and industry, from fashion to space exploration. It just goes to show inspiration can come from the last place you'd expect. The next time you're in the great outdoors, keep your eyes open. You never know what you might come up with.